Howdy, I'm Richard Azariga, a principal software engineer in Microsoft's Commercial Software Engineering Division. Today, I'll share a brief overview of the Microsoft Graph SDK for PHP and how you can use it to build powerful applications connected to Microsoft and Office 365. The PHP SDK is a perfect example of Microsoft's commitment to the open source community and providing SDKs on platforms that developers want to use. Before I jump into a demo, let me cover some of the highlights of the SDK. First, the Microsoft Graph SDK for PHP is fully open sourced on GitHub, so you can clone that repo, or you can simply incorporate it into your PHP project using Composer. The SDK is decoupled from authentication, meaning you can use any authentication approach you want against Azure Active Directory. Simply provide the SDK with a valid access token using the set access token method. Although Microsoft does not provide authentication libraries for PHP, there are many in the open source community, including one made specifically for OAuth 2 with Azure AD. The PHP SDK is request-based and it offers strongly typed classes. This simplifies REST calls and all the JSON that goes in and out of the graph. You start using it by creating a request using the desired HTTP action. So these are going to be things like a GET, a POST, a PUT, a PATCH. Then you'll specify the endpoint that you want to perform that action on. You can even designate your return type using the setReturnType method. The Graph SDK supports both the V1 and beta endpoints in the graph. Just set the API version when you create the graph object that you'll be working with. In addition to that, the Graph SDK for PHP supports both the V1 and beta endpoints of the graph. You just simply need to set the API version when creating your graph object. The SDK also supports intelligent paging for graph endpoints that might return lots of results. So rather than dealing with all like the O data next page details, the SDK handles all that for you. You simply create a pointer and say, hey, am I at the end? Or let's get the next page. Let's take a look at the SDK in more detail using a demo. Okay, I have a starter project here that basically already has all of the authentication details set up. So I have an auth helper PHP class that I use that I can say, go get an access token, and that's the token that I'm going to use to work with the Microsoft Graph SDK for PHP. So at this point, I need to incorporate that SDK into my project, and I'm going to do that using Composer. So I'm going to go out to a browser here, and I'm going to say Composer, and say I want to require Microsoft/Microsoft Graph. And that's going to go pull the Microsoft Graph SDK for PHP into my project, and I'll easily be able to work with that in this project. Okay, so now that that's finished, you can see that I have this vendors folder here that has that Microsoft Graph SDK, and I can start using it. For my page here, all I really need to use, because I'm using Composer, is just the require autoload that Composer does for me. So I'll go ahead and uncomment that so that it's included in my project. And now we can go and start using this SDK. Now the first thing I want to do in my page is I'm going to reference a few of the classes that are offered through the Graph SDK. So I'm going to say use Microsoft, and I'm going to do Microsoft Graph/Graph. And this is the actual graph client that we're going to perform operations on. And then finally, I'm also going to say Microsoft Graph/Model, which provides all those strongly typed classes that I can use to work more intelligently with the data I get from the graph. So here's the point where I actually have an access token. You can see I have some messages here, and what we're going to display is messages that I have in my inbox. Okay, now that we're referencing both the graph client and our models, let's set up an actual graph client object so that we can call into the graph. So what I'll do is just define a graph object here that's going to be a new graph, and what we need to do is inject our access token into this. So what we're going to do is call graph and we will call the set access token method. Now, the token that we get back from our auth helper actually contains a lot more details than an access token. It has a refresh token, an ID token. And so what we're going to do is actually call or send into this the token and say we want the access token part of it. All right, now that we've set our access token, we should be able to successfully call the graph. So let's actually set this up. And what we're going to do is query mail messages out of our account. And so to do that, that is potentially could be a lot of mail messages. So we're going to use some of that intelligent paging that I mentioned earlier. So we'll set up a pointer here, and we'll set that equal to graph. And what we're going to call on this, remember, I'm going to create a request. And in this case, it is a request for a collection. So we'll say create collection request. And in that, I need to specify two things. First, the verb. We're going to do a get, but I could just as easily do a post, a delete, or whatever I need to. And then I need to specify the endpoint that we're going to perform that action on. In this case, it's going to be /messages. All right, that's our endpoint. We now need to convert what comes back in that REST request as a strongly typed class. And the way we do that is on this, we can call the set return type. And in this case, the return type we're expecting is a model slash message. That's the type of class. So we'll go ahead and specify that. And then finally, what we can do is specify any sort of additional things. In this case, I could set my page size. So we'll do a set page size, and we'll just set it to 10. We'll get 10 at a time. Now, that's actually not performing the query. What is going to perform the query is when I actually use my pointer. So I already have an empty array here of messages. So instead, if I wanted to just set that to maybe the first 10 messages, I could say pointer.getPage. So it's basically fetching a page. In this case, it's safe to do this the first time around because I know I'm going to get some result back. But at some point, if I'm actually iterating through this, I might want to check to see if I've completed all of the queries for this endpoint. So I think we have everything we need to here to test this out. I'm using the PHP debugging extensions here in Visual Studio Code, so I can actually test this here in a browser. We'll go ahead and just start debugging, and I'll open a browser window here, and we'll go to localhost 888, build, and index.php. So you can see it's having me sign in, and then it's going to return back with my token, and we can step over this. And in this case, it did not find, I referenced that wrong to just getting confused with different versions of, or different coding platforms, but we'll fix that here really quick. And now, if I go back and refresh our page, what we should see if I step over this is we have messages. So you can see there's a bunch of messages here. I could go look into the details of this, but these are strongly typed, so I could go bind them to my UI pretty easily. Here I'm already iterating through the messages, so I could do things like, let's just do a maybe a message, and let's look at the maybe get sender. And then on the sender, maybe what we want to look at is get email address. And then finally, we can do a get name. So that'll get me the name that's passed in here, and I can do this for all of the properties that I'm interested in. I'll do some more simple ones here. So we could do something like get subject and so forth. So I'll stop at that at this point, and we'll see if that binds to our UI. So we'll go ahead and refresh this one more time. I'll just let it play over our breakpoint. And you can see we have our actual properties coming back. So super nice here being able to use that SDK to not have to deal with all the details of REST and headers. It handles all of that for us, including a lot of the paging. You can get started developing with the Microsoft Graph SDK for PHP right away using these links. All of the Microsoft Graph SDKs are offered open source on GitHub, so you can submit feedback, look at issues, and even contribute pull requests. You'll also find a number of samples that are out there for all of the different platforms we support. Finally, we're active where developers are active. So check us out on Stack Overflow and post your questions using the tag Microsoft Graph.